Dear friends, today we'll be seeing what is the meaning of execution of a complete instruction. So what do you understand by a complete instruction? So when a computer executes a particular command, you get the fruitful output. So this is a part of your complete execution and getting the desired output. Now let us consider the case when the computer is processing a command and you are not getting the desired output. There will be some sort of errors, syntax error or misspelled error. So do you think that this is a part of complete instruction? Yes, if you're getting the error, it also becomes a part of the complete instruction because computer has executed that instruction and there was a error in that instruction and it is giving you that output as the result. So let us understand the execution of a complete instruction with the help of one command, add R1 comma bracket R2. So here there are two variables. You can consider R1 and R2. Now R2 is in bracket, means it is indirectly pointing towards a memory location. The instruction R1 adds the contents of register R1 and the contents of memory location specified by R2 and stores the results in the register R1. Now you should remember, when a bracket is being given, it indicates that it is pointing towards the memory location where the contents are stored and you need to get the contents from that location, then are added with the content of the register R1 and then store the result. You fetch the instruction, you fetch the first operand, the content of memory pointed by the R2, perform the addition and load the result into R1. This is a simple process. Now let us add some variable to it. Now suppose that if R1 contains number 5, add 5 comma bracket, R2 contains 4. Now this is, the 4 is pointing towards a memory location which contains number 10. So number 10 plus 5 will give 15 and the output will be 15, which will be stored in register R1. Now execution of branch instruction, we have seen that branch instructions are very, very important because it allows your CPU to execute the different sort of instructions that are being linked with it. A branch instruction replaces the contents of PC with the help of branch target address, what we have seen in the previous modules, which is usually obtained by adding an offset X given in the branch instruction. The offset X is usually the difference between the branch target address and the address which is of the branch instruction. So you should understand offset. When you want to find what is the offset, you should target only two things. One is what is the branch instruction, where it is stored, and what is the branch target address and the address immediately following the branch instruction. Now, execution of branch instruction. Now, control sequence for unconditional branch. So here, it is the unconditional branch. It is not in a sequential way. It is as follows. PC out means you are getting the data out, comma, MAR means memory address register, putting the data into the register, MAR in. You need to perform the read operation. You need to select 4, add, and then you need to add all of these in the column Z in. Z may be a variable and in is the positioning. It is telling push the contents into Z in. Then you have Z out, which is pop out. That is Z out comma PC in. Again, the push instruction, comma whatever the contents of Y in, and with W M F C. Then you have MDR out. MDR out means memory data register. Out means you need to put out the contents from memory data register into the out phase, which is directly being connected with instruction register in. Now, as soon as these instructions are carried out, that is MDR out, comma, instruction register in, the contents will be stored into MDR. Now, we had seen one word into the second instruction. If you remember, WFMFC, it means that wait for memory fully complete. So wait for the memory to get the instruction fully done and then process the next instructions which are associated with it. The first three steps constitute the opcode fetch operation. Now, with the help of these three instructions, PC out, Z out, MDR out, we will be fetching the opcode fetch operation. Offset field of IRO, select Y, add Z. The contents of PC and the offset field of instruction register are added and stored in the result in register Z. Then you have Z out, comma PCL, and then the end command. In case of a conditional branch instruction, the status of the condition code specified in the instruction is checked. If the status specified within the instruction matches with the current status of condition code, the branch target address is loaded into the PC by adding the offset that has been specified in the instruction. Otherwise, processor fetches the next instruction. Now, when we are performing the branch instruction with respect to the offset, it should contain the status specified within the instruction. If the status specified matches the current status of the condition code, the branch target address is loaded. It is loaded into the PC by adding the offset. Now, let us look at this example. It contains the micro instructions as well as the control signals. The micro instructions have been divided into three types: instruction fetch, operand fetch, and then you have the execute cycle. And what will be the control signals that will be executing? Now, simultaneously, let us look into it. First, instruction fetches. The data from the PC is directly going towards MAR, that is memory address register. Now, memory address register bracket, memory bracket MAR means it is indirectly connected to the location where the contents of memory address register are stored and the data has been passed to MDR, memory data register. Then the content of PC plus 1 is directly going towards PC. Then you have the opcode of MDR, memory data register, bracket opcode, the contents are passing towards the instruction register. Operand fetch, here it is not being required. Execution cycle, execute cycle 4,5. The content of register R1 directly goes to Y, the content of Z directly goes to R2 plus Y, and R1 directly goes to Z. And what are the different control signals that are being assigned? For first, PC out, MAR in, it is performing the read operation and you need to select 4 and add Z in. For the second operation, it is control signals as Z out, PC in, Y in, and wait for memory function complete, that is called as your WMFC. If it is MDR out, it is instruction register that is in. R1 out, comma Y in. R2 out, select Y, add, and in. Here you are performing the add operation and you are selecting the variable as select Y. Then you have Z2, Z out, comma R1 in, and you end the code. So, in this entire operation, if you see what we have read out, from starting of PC out, where you are pushing the data into the computer, then the memory is reading the data, that is with the help of MAR, then you are performing the read operation, then you are selecting the selecting 4 and then add and Z in. Similarly, when you're putting the data into the Z variable, you need to pull out the data, so you're using Z out. Again, PCN, Y in, and then you're performing the operation, memory function complete. So wait for memory function complete. Here, the meaning of wait for memory function complete is to wait till the all the instructions are being getting executed simultaneously. Then you have MDR out, comma, instruction register in phase. Then you have R1 out, comma, Y in. R1 out means you are putting the data out of the register. That is, you are popping out the data. Then you are putting the register in, R2 out, and you select the variable Y and you add the content into Z in. And again, the Z in will have the sum value, which will directly go to Z2. Now, if you read these instructions simultaneously, you will come to know that the control signals are running in the form of the pipeline architecture. The output of one signal becomes the input to the other signal. This is how the control signals work.